the innocent victims of crime have frequently been overlooked by our criminal justice system, and their pleas for justice have gone unheeded.
When I look back into the history of the victims' movement, I'm amazed at how far we've come.
Crime victims, at one point in the criminal justice system, were an afterthought.
Victims felt very isolated. First of all, they were blamed. Why were you on that street? Why did you do that? Why did you open your door? And it wasn't until some of the grassroots organizations made people aware that, hey, these are people that are suffering. They need our help.
Now, victims in the system have rights that generations ago weren't recognized.
We were able to create an Office for Victims of Crime in the Department of Justice. That was huge.
People are more aware of trauma-informed practices. And how do we make sure the voices of who we're advocating for are included in the way that we design services?
When systems are not connected, there's a high likelihood that people are falling through the cracks.
And our job is done more effectively in a collaboration.
We're for healing, we're for building a community, we're for reestablishing a strong foundation so our communities are better places.
So the more we build the circle and the bigger the circle gets, the healthier communities we have.